so. Really? Yeah, we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah.
Today, from Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis, it's week 7 of the NFL on EA Sports. Colts taking on the Denver Broncos.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way. These folks are fired up. Start this drive in the air, dancing to his left, and he's going to keep it here, and he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there, but he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the
first. And oh, right away, he lost the football. Able to fall on it, but look where they recovered it. That's a big loss.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Hill, the intended receiver once again, and it's third down.
Third down and long.
On play action, they'll throw. They're going deep for Hill. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He'll run it. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out. They open downfield. He keeps it himself.
First down, but no one was open, so he gets flushed out of the pocket, runs towards the sidelines, gets out of bounds with a good gain and a first down.
And going deep for Hill. And incomplete on the deep ball. A little too aggressive defensively, and the flag comes out.
And no one trying to cover is going to like a call going against them, but you have to like the effort there. Went for the interception, just unable to get it, and the flag did come out.
This is caught. And the Colts are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one. Sets him up nicely. First and goal. It was a pickup of 14 toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
Second and one. Steps away to his left. And he's going to find Doyle in the end zone for a Colts score. Jack Doyle, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Colts are going to take a first quarter. Throw now on first down. And now a fumble. The ball's out. It's picked up by the Broncos. And the return will stop right around the 25.
Fumble on the play. Recovered by Denver.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Buying time to his left. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. That's good for 28 yards.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Forced out to his left. He'll try and run it. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
A gain of five brings up second and five.
And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. 22 yards there, a first down. They'll run it here. This is Marlon Mack. A gain of three, second down. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Being chased out left. And now he's going to use his legs. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Bradley Chubb doing what he does best, getting that sack. Now a play fake here on first down. Dancing to his left. And going deep for Hill. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks.
And the Broncos get there and take him down. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. Look to throw here. Steps away to his left. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. And this will not get close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the 26. Now the Broncos going to use this. Back to throw now in his own end zone. And going deep for Hill. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way down to the 35. Back to throw now on first down. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Flush to his right. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that is caught. But how about that one? He reeled it in one-handed for a touchdown. That could be an important swing right there. A touchdown in the final minute of the half to take the lead.
And I like the point you just made there. Could be an important swing because now that they have the lead, if they can carry that into the locker room at the half, they'll feel really good about what they accomplished in the first two quarters.
Down, he'll drop to throw it. Left side, Doyle with it. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That goes for a gain of 31. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10.
So when's the best time to take the big shots downfield? When you think a defense least expects it, and I think the first play of the third quarter qualifies. They came right out firing. That's how you send a message to start the second half of a game.
13 yards as they've got the connection working. His second catch in a row, first down. They'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. Throw left side complete. That's Doyle. And down inside the 15 he goes. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. That's caught at the 3. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. It'll go as a loss on the play, not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down. To throw on third and goal. This will be caught at about the 5. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. Back now in Indianapolis. All even as we get ready to start the 4th. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Forced out to his left. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Second and 11. And he's going to go down again.
The quarterback,
Bradley Chubb, able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his 3rd sack of the afternoon.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
They'll wind up with 17 on that one, but they're still a bit short here. He'll drop to throw. Being chased out left. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Doyle. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds.
Oh, why are we doing this?
That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books. But now they have to make that up again, don't they?
Dan, throw left side complete. That's Doyle. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. Steps away to his left. He's going to take off with it, and he'll be out right at the 35. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first.
How many times have we seen this late in the 4th quarter? Because you know the pass rush is getting after him, and they get upfield, get that great push, and what do they create? Space, and he takes off.
And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. That one goes for 30 yards. Now the Colts moving quickly here in the hurry-up offense. Back to throw. That one complete to Hill. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark it down at the 9. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic well over 100 yards.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing, the route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down.
At the 6-yard line.
buying time to his left. His pass caught at the four. Only able to pick up two, and that leads us to third and goal.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. It just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
Forced out to his, and that's going to be caught. Touchdown. And they've broken our tie here in the final minute.
I don't know how many more of these my heart can take, my man. I just don't know. Another big touchdown. Late in the game, they look like they're in control, but still, there's a chance. Block the extra point, go down and score, kick the extra point.
Well, no doubt an electrifying finish to have it down inside the 10-yard line. That final shot, though, they couldn't get it in the end zone, and that's all she wrote.
And they had the final shot. The last snap taken that close to the end zone. They don't get it in, so they'll regret that. But flip it over, making a stand in that portion of the field, congratulations to them.
So for Indianapolis, their strong start to the year continues as they're up to 5-1. And they will hit the road next week. Meanwhile, for Denver, the losses are piling up as they drop to 1-5 now. And they'll try to get back on track next week as they head up to Orchard Park to take on the Buffalo Bills. So for our entire crew,